In this video, I will demonstrate how you can import character information from a text file into your database. I will import information from following text file. My file contains well-defined tables with rows corresponding to my samples. The first row of my text file contains the column names. The first column lists the unique IDs of my samples. The second, third, and fourth column contain some additional sample information. The other columns hold the character values. After import, these values will be stored in a character type experiment. In my database, no character type experiment has been defined yet. To create a character type experiment, I press this button in the Experiments panel. I choose character type and press OK. In the first step, I need to specify the name of my character type experiment. In the second step of the wizard, I need to specify the type of data I will store in this experiment. I will import numerical values so I can leave the default option checked. Since all my values are integers, I do not need to alter the second setting and I can go to the last step. Since the number of characters is fixed for all my samples, I have a so-called closed data set, so I can keep the selection. The layout of my card can still be changed after creation of the experiment, so I can press Finish. The character experiment is created and is added to the Experiments panel. After import, my samples will be displayed in the Database Entries panel. This panel is located on the left-hand side in the main window. The key field is a default information field. More fields can be added by right-clicking in the header of the panel or during import. When I press the import button in the main window, the first option under the topic Character Type Data allows me to import database and character information from a text file. When I click on Import, I need to browse for the text file in the next step. I click on Next, and in the next step, I need to create an import template for my data format. The column names found in the text file are listed under the column source. In this grid, I can choose what information I would like to import into my database. The first column in my text file contains my entry IDs. To link this information to the key field, I click on the first row in the grid, press the Edit Destination button, and select the key item from the list. The grid information is updated. Further, I would like to write the content of the genus, species, and type columns to new information fields in my database. With the Control key, I can select multiple rows in the grid. I then select Edit Destination and select the Entry Info Field option from the list. I am prompted to give my fields a name. The column names that appear in my text file are suggested, but can be changed if desired. After confirmation, the grid is updated. Finally, I would like to link my other fields to the VNTR character type in my database. With the Shift key, I can select multiple rows at once. I select edit destination, and select the character type from the list. I am prompted to give my characters a name. The column names that appear in my text file are suggested, but can be changed if desired. After confirmation, the grid is updated. By clicking the preview button, I can check whether the columns have been assigned correctly. If so, I can close this window and press Next to go to the final step. As an entry link field, I will use the key, as this is a unique identifier for my entries. A name for my template is prompted for. Pressing OK saves the template to the database. I select the template and press Next to go to the final step. Pressing the Finish button starts the import. The imported entry information is displayed in the Database Entries panel. For each experiment defined in the database, there is a column present in the Experiment Presence panel. Since in my database only one experiment is present, only one column is present here. A colored dot is displayed if character information is linked to the entry. To view the character information of a certain entry, I can click on the corresponding colored dot. But before opening the card, I will change the default card settings. I double-click on the experiment, open the settings dialog, select the experiment card tab, and change the representation to list. The card can be opened by clicking on the colored dot in the middle panel. All characters and values are shown. To close the card, I need to click in the upper left corner of the card. This ends this video. For other import and analysis routines, I invite you to view our other movies. Thank you for watching.